Leann Davis and I'm a second grade teacher. This year I created a curriculum unit all on sustainable housing. We started by researching and reviewing a social studies unit that we did earlier in the year with Native Americans. And then once we visited that unit, we took a look and broke off the United States into six main regions. And so then we talked a little bit about how each region has different types of weather and different things that happen that could affect people's homes, depending on where the region is that they live. Then we grabbed some nonfiction texts that the kids broke off into small groups with, and they read and looked for key main ideas. Then they were taking a closer look at some of the major catastrophes, like forest fires, earthquakes, volcanoes, tornadoes, all those different kinds of things, and researched a little bit closer with each region. We talked about engineering. We asked the kids to use local resources when building their homes. We also touched on the artistic side of homes and took a look in a virtual field trip, actually, of Frank Lloyd Wright. I was so excited to see how they were able to take that architecture that they were studying from Frank Lloyd Wright and then bring it into their sketches that they were creating about their homes from their regions. And just actually they brought in some things like spiral staircases and some of the pillars that held up that adobe shelter. It was just amazing and magical to see how they were tying in that art to that engineering process. So then after they designed and had their sketches, they created these designs and brought in all kinds of different materials from that region to represent from that region. So we had like some clay for the adobe homes. We had the magnet tiles represent the glass structures. By the beach, we had some Lincoln logs, of course, from the forest. We talked a little bit about using some of the mud and the moss for the hobbit holes that they did in the Great Plains region. And, of course, Legos. Who doesn't like to build with Legos? After the presentations, we worked in a small group, and we went ahead and we integrated those technology standards into a program called Tinkercad. And the kids actually worked with me together to create their homes on a 3D printer. And of course, after we were done, we had a few older students that helped polish these homes up and make them perfect. So a lot of our third graders came in and helped out with that, and an amazing sixth grader. Whew, we found his 3D CAD skills, and we found his 3D CAD skills to be out of this world. So thank you so much to here and those third graders to help us. Check out these presentations.
Study the mountains, and our natural resources are stone and wood.
Our home is a log cabin.
And our natural disasters are fires.
Action.
Our region is the Hawaiian coastal.
Our natural resources is glass, sand, and water.
Our home is glass and cement.
And our natural disaster is volcanoes. We built a ceramic wall to protect
and put a solar
us.
Panel.
And we put a little wall for the entrance so you can't get burned.
Our homes are the igloos, and our natural disasters are blizzards.
And we put holes on top of our homes for the fire to escape, so our homes don't melt.
For the heat to escape, right out of it,
from the chimney.
Our region is Great Plains.
Our natural resources are grass and mud.
Our home is a hobbit hole.
And our natural disasters are
tornadoes.
I thought since our thing was tornadoes, the hobbit hole, how the guy could be safe, I thought, why not make a hole? Which means the guy could escape from that and be safe because the hole would lead underground out, so he would be safe until the tornado leaves.
And I thought that if a person's on the hole on the side of the house that the other hobbit hole is, I thought we could put another hobbit hole on the other side.
Our region is the southern.
Our natural resources are sand, clay, and mud.
Our home is adobe.
Our natural disasters are hurricanes.
We built this clay house on pillars like Frank Lloyd Wright.
So we made it adobe.
So much through this unit. They learned not only about like science, but they were able to collaborate with one another. This unit helped them to look as a scientist into how, not just like what affects the earth, but how it changes. And they were able to become like their future engineer self and use those hands, those little hands in the clay, and they were building and they were learning that engineering design process, and they were just super fully engaged with so many different learning styles that this impacted, and it helped bring out like the true artists in each of them, and they were able to see how they could work together to build something beautiful in the world.